Good morning, everybody. How are we all doing? Can we all stand together? Beautiful day out there. Amen. Come on, let's get in the mood to worship the Lord. How about that? It's July. Yeah, put those hands together. Come on. We see prison cells, we see graveyards, we see broken lives and hopeless hearts. But faith sees a miracle, looking for a home. We see armies rise, we face lions' dance. We hear giants roar, you will never win. But faith sees a miracle, looking for a home. I believe in miracles. I believe in miracles. I can see a miracle. Faith sees a miracle, looking for a home. We see deserts, but we smell the rain. Hear the thunder, glory's on the way. Faith sees a miracle, looking for a home. Come on, I believe in miracles, claim it today. Of the kingdom, we open the doorway of heaven. We're holding the keys of the kingdom. We open the doorway of heaven. Sing it again. We're holding the keys of the kingdom. We open the doorway of heaven. We're holding the keys of the kingdom. We open the doorway of heaven. We're holding the keys of the kingdom. We open the doorway of heaven. I believe in miracles. I believe in miracles. Do you? Looking for a home. Come on, give him a clap offering today. He's worthy. He is worthy. I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. A man's empty praise and treasures. Back together, and every desire is now satisfied here in your love. nothing is better than you. Sing it again. Oh, there's nothing better. Come on, tell them. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. I'm not afraid to show you. Failures and flaws, Lord, you've seen them. You still call me through. 'Cause the God of the mountain is the God of the valley. There's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. Tell them again. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing. Nothing is better than you. You turn morning to day. Close your eyes, forget about everybody else here. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better. Come on, pretend it's just you and Jesus. Tell him. Oh, there's nothing better. It again. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. Come on, give him one last shout. Woo! Amen.
Well, we always like to start our new month and our week by coming to the communion table. If you are watching us live stream, make sure you get your elements, a cracker, a piece of bread, some juice there at home. Those of you that are here, you should have received your elements on the way in. If you did not, hold your hand up high and one of the ushers will get them to you at this time, please. Lord, it was on the night that you were soon about to be betrayed, that you had us on your mind. You took bread, signifying your own body that was broken. For you were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was on you, Lord, and with and by your stripes we were and we are the healed. Come on, just declare, I am the healed. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And then, Lord, after supper, you lifted a cup because you're a covenant God, and you said, take and drink. For this is the blood of a new, a better covenant shed for the remission of our sins. Lord, you said as often as we would do this to remember you. So our thoughts, our attention, our focus goes to Calvary this morning. For it was there you paid in full the price. And you declared, it is finished. Thank you, Lord. Just declare with me, Father, in Jesus' name, I forgive anyone that has hurt me, wounded or rejected me. I release out of my heart any ill feelings of bitterness, resentment, anger, and all unforgiveness. I let go now of grudges, any offenses toward anyone. In Jesus' name. All right, if there's anyone you need to forgive, just want you right now, just release them. Any ill feelings that are pent up in your heart and spirit, just let it go now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Lord. And then let's continue to pray. And now, dear Jesus, I thank you for the cross, for it was there. You took all my sins, all my sicknesses, all my diseases. I am forgiven. I am healed and made whole by the blood of the Lamb. Amen. All right, take your wafer now. And as Christ's body was broken so that you and I could be whole and healed, take and break and eat it and be healed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Daddy. And then as Christ lifted a cup, we lift our cups and we take and drink, be washed and cleansed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. When you're finished, the ushers will gather the elements. And let's just continue to bless the Lord.
All-consuming fire,
You're our heart's desire, living flame of love. Come baptize us, come baptize us. All-consuming fire, all-consuming fire. You're our heart's desire, you're our heart's desire. Living flame of love, living flame of love. Come baptize us, come baptize us. Sing it again, all-consuming fire, all-consuming fire. You're our heart's desire. Living flame of love, living flame of love. Come baptize us, come baptize us. Let us fall more in love. Fall more in love with you. Come on, sing it. Let us fall more in love with you. Let us fall more in love. All-consuming fire. All-consuming fire. You're our heart's desire. Living flame of come baptize us, come baptize us. All-consuming fire, all-consuming fire. You're our heart's desire. Living flame of love, come baptize us, come baptize us. Let us fall more in love with you. 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 We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love, love. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love. Come on, sing. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love, love. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love. Sing it again. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love, love. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love, love. We want to know how high, how deep, how wide is love, love, love. Once more. All-consuming fire, you're our heart's desire. Living flame of love, come baptize us, come baptize us.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's keep worshiping Him. Hallelujah. He is a great God. How great you are. That's the name of this next song.
A thousand sparkling stars upon a midnight summer sky. The majesty and wonder of the ocean's endless tide. And the more I see, the more I can't explain how the one who set the world in place could even know my name. tell him how great you are, how great you are, how small I am, how awesome is your mighty hand. And I am captured by the wonder of it all. And I will offer all my praise for all my heart, for all my days. How great you are, how great you are, how great you are. A million snowflakes gently fall, yet no two are the same. The colors fill the canvas of the seasons as they change. And everywhere I look, I see your hand. Why you would love someone like me, I'll never understand. And I'm a man. So amazed. How great you are, how small I am, how awesome is your mighty hand. And I am captured by the wonder of it all. And I will offer all my praise with all my heart for all my days. How great you are, how great you are, how great you are. How great you are, how great you are, how great you are. How great you are, how great you are, how great.
Come on, praise his name. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We honor you, Lord God. Hallelujah, 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 Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Come on, let's yield our hearts to him this morning.
Teach us how to be one with you. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, rest in this place. Teach us how to be one with you. I yield my heart to you. I yield my heart to you. I yield my heart to you. You're my king. You're my king. I yield my heart to you. I yield my heart to you. I yield my heart to you. You're my king. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, rest in this place. Teach us how to be one with you. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, rest in this place. Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, rest in this place. Teach us how to be one with you.
One more.
Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, rest in this place. Teach us how to be one with you.
Amen and amen. Come on, one last clap offering. Give him some praise. Amen. Good morning, family. A blessed 4th of July weekend to everyone. It is so, so good. Oh, it's hard to believe it's July already, isn't it? So good to be here with you in the presence of the Lord. Tomorrow, our nation celebrates its 246th birthday. Wow. Happy birthday, America. Amen. While we're still standing, let's just salute our flag today and honor our nation. Ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Amen.
God bless America.
It's the land. Seated, everyone in the house, thank you so much. If you are a guest joining us today, we welcome you and we're glad you have come to be a part of our service. Our ushers have a welcome packet that they'd like to place in your hands. Included in there is a complimentary beverage card. We have a Holy Ground Cafe right next door where lunch will be being served right after service. You could stop in there and get your complimentary beverage. So any guests that are with us, would you just hold your hand up good and high? And while the ushers are finding you and getting you that welcome packet, let's give all of our guests a nice welcome. Come on. Amen. And those of you that aren't guests, we're glad you came back. Remember, next Sunday, Pittsburgh Praise, come on. And I just saw they're calling for it to be 85 and sunny, no rain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let it be. So, next Sunday, we will have our morning worship service at 10 o'clock, immediately following. Pray the preacher doesn't go too long. We're going to have a complimentary lunch for everyone. All right? A complimentary lunch right next door in the cafe and cafeteria. at 12 o'clock, those of you that signed up for the buses, our buses, we're going to start loading the buses at 12 noon. We got beautiful, elite, air-conditioned bathroom handicap accessory buses. Only the best for greater works. How about that? Amen. So we want to load the buses at noon. By 12:30, we'd like to head out to Heinz Field because the gates open at 1 o'clock. Remember, we've got our Acts 29 t-shirts, and if you get one, they are $10. We've got them in all the different sizes. They're available right out in the lobby. If you do purchase a t-shirt, wear it next week so that we can identify all of our Greater Works family. And then those, the rest that are driving down separately, we will all meet together down at Heinz Field. Gates open at 1. The service is from 2 until 4. So immediately following the service, we'll bring everybody that rode the buses back up here to the church, okay? Remember the baby bottles. They're going to be due in just a couple of weeks. Hope you're filling them up with loose change, a check, some bills. We've given already almost $60,000 to the Women's Health Care Network. Isn't that exciting? Amen. That's wonderful. Wonderful. And our Synergy Youth, they had just an amazing time at Monroeville. They were there all this past week. I'm going to ask Pastor Danny and Beth to come on up and just share just a couple of quick things, right?
Yeah, good morning. We have a quick video that we just wanted to show you just to kind of highlight our week, and then and we'll share a little bit after. Go ahead and play that.
What? So Danny and I together just wanted to thank all of you guys. Oh, Joey's crying. He didn't like the applause. Okay, bud. But yeah, Danny and I just wanted to thank all of you guys because you guys were so impactful at getting our teens out there, and we were able to give scholarships to every single one of our students and get the bus with you guys' donation, and you guys really did just bless us and enabled, you know, for us to make that happen. So
I just wanted to just really quickly just give so much love to our students, all that went. We got truly, we got so many compliments from the people leading the camp. We came off the bus. All of our students had matching T-shirts on, which were purchased with your sponsorships. And the leaders of the camp that ran the whole camp came up to us and said, that's exactly what a youth ministry is supposed to look like when they come to camp. And then when it came to cleaning up, they were on top of everything. They were on their best behavior. You would have been proud of your kids if you sent your kids with us. So it was an amazing experience. I encourage you next year when we plan this that you encourage a young person in your life to come to camp with us. We had a couple youth ministries reach out to us and say, hey, we don't have a youth pastor, but if I knew that you were going, we would have sent our kids with your group because they were on point. And we were just so proud of them. So great job, guys. We're just so proud of you. All of our leaders stepped up.
We had a night where some of our students got filled with the Holy Spirit, too, and they learned baptism. Amen. Also.
It was amazing. There was an evening service where we saw chains broken over father wounds. We saw people healed. There was a healing service. There was a prophetic service. There was a service where they called down the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and some of our students got their prayer languages, and it was just an awesome Spirit-filled week. On top of all the fun and the games and all of that, the Holy Spirit was absolutely present. We saw our children. We saw some of our students just break out and just allow the fear of insecurity and all of that to go and just really just let go of everything they were holding on to. Wow. So they watched healings happen in their face. They saw a young lady who had sprained her ankle in the beginning of the week at the healing service on Friday or Thursday night. She got healed and was hopping around on that foot and walked out with her crutches in her hand. So it was amazing. So yes, it was awesome. Thank you.
All right. Amen. They're fired up. Thank you, Lord. That's wonderful. Amen. Let the fire fall. God is up to something. I'm telling you, He is up to something. Well, we are going to receive our morning tithes and our offerings. Come on, put your hands together. Today is Missions Sunday. And remember that starting tomorrow, the 4th, 5th, and 6th, we are having our vacation Bible school down in Haiti. Yes. Several hundred of our children are going to be in a vacation Bible school. Please keep them in prayer. And please keep the peace of the nation down there in your prayers as well. That they will just have an outpouring of God's love upon them. And that many of them will just have an experience with God during that vacation Bible school. Lori said that all of the supplies we sent arrived there, and she's been having Zoom meetings with all the teachers and the leaders and the workers there. But just keep everything in prayer for the next 3 days, the 4th, 5th, and 6th, okay? So let's pray over the tithes and offerings. Father, we thank you for meeting and exceeding our budget for this month of July. Lord, we know it's summertime, but we declare a summer jump, a summer harvest, and not a summer slump. And Lord, we choose not to participate in this inflation and recession. We trust Jireh. We put our trust in you, and we thank you that you are our source and you're our provider. Meet every need of this house and every need in our personal houses and lives in Jesus Christ's name. And everybody said, All right, our ushers will serve us. If you're writing out a check, make it payable to Greater Works. Those of you that prefer or like to do your giving by credit or debit card, the Resource Center will be open in the corner of the lobby right after service. Those of you watching us online, you can do your giving, you can do your missions giving online through Easy Tithe. Thank you for your faithfulness. The Lord bless you abundantly.
Step out of the shadows. Step out of the grave. Break into the wild. And don't be afraid. Run into wide open spaces. Grace is waiting for you. Dance like the weight has been lifted. Grace is waiting where the Spirit of the Lord. There is freedom where the Spirit of the Lord is. There is freedom. There is freedom. Come out of the dark just as you are into the fullness of His love. For the Spirit is here. Let there be freedom. Let there be freedom.
Let's all stand together in the house. Lay your hand on your tithe, if you're tithing, on your offering, on your missions gift. I bless you with the blessing of the Lord that makes rich. And God, you add no sorrow to your blessing in our lives. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Chains will fall. Prisons shake at the sound of Jesus' name. Lives made whole, hearts awake at the sound of Jesus' name. Chains will fall, prisons shake at the sound of Jesus' name. Lives made whole, hearts awake at the sound of Jesus' name. Yeah, where the Spirit.
Provision for our lives. Hallelujah. Amen. Please remain standing for our corporate prayer time. Remember, at the conclusion of the message, there will be altar workers available down here in the front. If anybody needs prayer for healing, how many believe there's a healer in the house today? Jehovah Rapha is in the house. Or you need just a prayer of agreement for anyone or anything that's on your heart, make sure you come down and receive that prayer today. I'm going to ask Suri and Tammy if you could come on down and help us to pray. We want to keep Joan Walton in our prayers. We prayed last week. She was in a pretty bad car accident. She's now in a rehab in Coriopolis. We're praying for her. We are praying for Mary Lynn Zackling's son, Darren. He was in a car accident. He's in surgery this morning. We want to pray for him. And we are praying for Gloria Dalms. Her brother back in Spain went home to be with the Lord. And we want to pray and keep Gloria and her family. Some of her cousins are here visiting from Spain. We want to keep them in prayer. Skip Rose, his precious wife, Jacqueline also went home to be with the Lord. Skip, we're holding you up. Latanya Brown, her stepfather, went home to be with the Lord. So we're keeping Latanya and her mother in our prayers. And then, of course, Tim Hart, his sister Pam, she also went home to be with the Lord. So lots of folks need comfort, and many people need healing. You folks just finished up your glory conference, right? Did the glory show up?
It did, with signs and wonders. And Pastor Gary, I wanted to say that on the first night, David Herzog prophesied that our region and the surrounding area was going to be a land of Goshen in the coming days. And I saw on Sunday, and I listened to your message, that you preached on living in the land of Goshen.
Yes, come on.
So it was just lining up. So that was just one of the many confirmations. And the second thing with our conference was David had also shared how he had just come from Israel, and he had saved two people from drowning on two different days.
Wow.
And so our son Micah, he was taking care of David, and just David prayed for him and all this. And 3 days ago, we were at Sandcastle, and Micah was in the deep end where the wave pool and the waves were coming. And Micah said that there was a boy, he was drowning. And the boy saw Micah and said, "Help, help, help." And Micah was able to get him by one hand and swim him to shore and save his life.
Amen.
So God was just confirming things. So praise Amen. God. Hallelujah. So
would you pray? Who wants to pray? Just pray. That a lot of folks need comfort. The Dalms family, Skip Rose, Latanya, the Hart family. They all need comfort. And then a lot of people need healing. I know there's a healing anointing Amen. On you, Suri.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. You're the comforter, oh God, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Lord God Almighty, heal the brokenhearted, Lord Jesus, oh God. Let the spirit of comfort come into their families, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord, every spirit of depression and oppression be broken now in the name of Jesus, oh God. Let the healing power flow into their hearts, oh God, now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, Father God, the people who are sick, oh Lord, the people who are broken, their bones, oh God, in the accidents, oh God, you're the God who can heal the people, oh God, Jesus. I speak to the bones, the broken bones, to be restored now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Every plans or purpose of the enemy be broken in the name of Jesus, oh God, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Creative miracles, oh God. Hallelujah. Speak life. The resurrection power flow into them, oh God, and heal them, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Spirit of God, move in this place, oh God. As you promised, oh God, your glory and the resurrection power begin to flow into this place. Oh, Father God, resurrect the bodies, oh God. Hallelujah. Lord, your word says, oh Father, Lord, if we believe, oh Father, that eternal life is going to flow out of us, oh God. The life is going to flow. You're the resurrection, oh God. I speak to every sick body, oh God, now. I command the sickness to depart in the name of Jesus. Loose them and set them free. Power flow now. Heal them, oh God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord.
I have a word.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So I just also speak to anybody that has cancer. I just saw that God was restoring and healing people's body of cancer. So right now, in the name of Jesus, I take authority over that foul spirit of cancer in Jesus' name, and I command it to go in Jesus' name. I command tumors, growths to drop off, to dissolve, to disappear, to shrivel up and to die in the name of Jesus. And there's somebody, and I don't know if it's like throat cancer, something with the throat. God is healing and touching you right now. And I also see like there's like growths and things like on the outside of the skin, bumps that are protruding out. God is removing them. There's something about growths, tumors, and cancers. God is touching you and setting you free and healing you in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah. And Lord, I just pray, Father, for Pastor Gary. Lord, I thank you, Father, for the anointing that is upon him. I pray, Father, for the glory of God to descend in this place like never before. I thank you, Father, that the words that he speaks will come out with power, that they will convict hearts and touch your people. And Lord, I thank you, Father, that this will be a place where your glory will abide, it will remain, and it will stay. Father, I thank you, Lord, for miracles, signs, and wonders yes. being released. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you. Bless you. Thank you. All right. Amen. You may be seated, everyone. Thank you, worship team. Thank you. Thank you. Loretta and Doc, you just celebrated an anniversary, right? How many years? 26 years. Congratulations. I always ask her if there's a doctor in the house, and she always says, my doctor. And Nancy, you and your husband, 57 years? 57 years. Wow. Would you get married when you were like 12 or something? You, huh? You don't look that old. You don't look that old at all. God bless you. That's wonderful. Well, let's get into the word. Let freedom ring. You know, the Liberty Bell, which is located in Independence Hall in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, it is an iconic symbol of America's freedom. And it's interesting because inscribed right on the Liberty Bell is a scripture. It's Leviticus 25 and verse 10. And it says, proclaim liberty through all the land unto all the inhabitants thereof. And you know, our nation, I truly believe, was founded on biblical principles. Even though maybe a lot of our founding fathers might not have been, quote, born again, I believe many of them were God-fearing. And I believe those men that gathered to write our Constitution, there had to be an anointing upon them. Because our Constitution is like a timeless document, still proclaiming our liberties today. And yet, I always quote Dr. Ed Cole, who says, it's easier to obtain than it is to maintain. It's one thing to get free. It's another thing to stay free. And so, in Psalm 11 and verse 3, it says this, if the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? If the foundations are destroyed, if you have a crack in your foundation, anything you build upon it is not going to be solid. And number one, our nation, it was built on a biblical foundation. But it's up to us now. Paul said in Galatians 5 and verse 1, stand fast. Stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has made you free, and do not be entangled again in the yoke of bondage. We've got to fight to stay free. We've got to stand on our liberties. We have to wake up, rise up, and push back in Jesus Christ's name. In 1 Kings chapter 18, remember when Elijah the prophet, he faced the 450 false prophets of Baal. And remember, he stood before the people on Mount Carmel, and he said, how long are you going to halt between two opinions? How long are you going to waver? If God is God, let's serve him. If Baal is God, then let's serve him. But get off the fence. We cannot serve God with one foot in the kingdom and one foot in the world. Let's get both feet in the fire. Come on. And in 1 Kings 18 and verse 20, so Ahab sent for all the children of Israel, and he gathered the prophets together on Mount Carmel. And Elijah came to all the people and he said, how long will you falter between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered not a word. I think they were convicted. Then Elijah said to the people, I alone am left the prophet of the Lord. But Baal's prophets are 450 men. And then if you jump down to verse 30, it says this, then Elijah said to all the people, come near to me. So all the people came near to him. And look at the first thing that he did before he called fire down. He repaired the altar of the Lord that was broken down. I always like to use the four legs of a chair as our foundation spiritually. Time in the Word. I hope you read the Word every single day of your life. Meditate on it day and night. Time in prayer, your quiet time, your church attendance, and your tithing. Those are the four legs of the chair. That's the foundation. And so often when anyone Christian has trouble in any area of their life, I always say, go back to your foundation. Because if your foundation is cracked, if your foundation is weakened, it's going to affect anything else you build on it. And our nation has a biblical foundation. Our nation has a foundation that was based on biblical principles. And yet we've all known that our nation in many ways has gotten off track. Our nation in many ways is going in a direction that is not pleasing to God. A recent poll said 78% of all Americans believe that our nation's going in the wrong direction. Oh God, we need a divine reversal. God, we need a divine turnaround. God, we need a revival. Hallelujah. And that's why I'm so grateful that next week the body of Christ will be gathering in unity at Heinz Field for worship, for prayer, and for asking the Lord to rend the heavens and come down. Lord, send a revival. And let it begin right here at greater works right here in Western Pennsylvania, right here in the Church of Pittsburgh. But in the last 2 weeks, we have seen major victories that have restored and upheld religious freedoms guaranteed by our Constitution. And I'm absolutely convinced it's because of one reason, because the effectual, fervent prayers of righteous men and women avail much. We can't slack. We can't pull back. We got to continue to press on and push forward. Let me just share with you that one of them was Carson versus Macon. In a 6-3 decision, the Supreme Court ruled that religious schools can't be excluded from a main program that offers tuition aid for private education. This means that if a state offers school vouchers so that parents can choose the best education for their children, those vouchers or that state funding can be used to send them to private schools, even if they are religious based. That's big. Then one you might be a little more familiar with is Kennedy versus Bremerton School District. The Supreme Court ruled in favor of Coach Joe Kennedy, who had been fired from his coaching job at Bremerton School District in the state of Washington. The school had told the Coach Kennedy he could not pray on the football field following his team's game on Friday nights. The court said the Constitution protected private religious expression, including praying in public. That's big. I'm believing God is going to restore prayer back in schools again. Come on, somebody. Matt Geppard, who we are working with here on Pittsburgh Praise, he's from CPAC, and he's a missionary who goes overseas a lot and works in a lot of the foreign countries in the Far East. But he said, don't anybody tell me God cannot restore prayer back in our public schools. He said, we work with the schools in Cambodia. Cambodia is a communist country. And he said, in thousands of Cambodian schools, they begin every day praying the Lord's Prayer. Because they're in the schools working with social programs and they have favor and influence there. And he said, if God can have Cambodian students in a communist country praying, then I know God can restore prayer back in America again. What the devil has stolen, my God will restore. You can go right back to the time when prayer and Bible reading was removed from our schools, and that's when things went down, 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 down. And they have been going ever since. And even though you could throw money at education, that's not the answer. The answer is Jesus. Come on, some. I said the answer is Jesus. And then, of course, the one we're most excited about, Dobbs versus Bremerton. versus Jackson Women's Health Organization in a ruling that upheld Mississippi's 2018 law banning virtually all abortions after the 15th week of pregnancy. The Supreme Court, they went a step farther and they reversed its nearly 50-year-old Roe v. Wade national legalized abortion decision, the 6-3 decision following the Constitution, by giving back the rights to the states on abortion issues. Somebody ought to give God a shout of praise. Come on. Hallelujah. It was in 1973. This is the 50th year, the year of Jubilee. Come on. That God reversed it. And now our state election in November is big, because right now we have a pro-abortion governor. He admits it. And he says if they send it back to Pennsylvania, he's not permitting. He's going to continue to allow abortions in Pennsylvania. But if we get a pro-life governor, oh Lord, oh Lord, give us a pro-life governor. And let Pennsylvania be a pro-life state. Come on, somebody. The Bible is so clear that we need to stand and give voice to the unborn, to the precious lives. Over 63 million babies have been murdered and aborted. And yet I believe that curse of death over our country has been broken in the strong name of Jesus the Christ of Nazareth. And I believe God is lining things up, and this next piece will be next Sunday at the Heinz Field, and I believe God is about to release an outpouring of the Holy Spirit like we have never seen before. I don't want you to miss next Sunday's message. God's put a clear word on my heart, a now word for what I believe is about to happen, and I don't want you to miss it. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 3, verse you know well, we just sang it. Paul says in verse 17, now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, thank God there's liberty. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, we're being transformed, we're being changed from glory to glory to glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. And my second point is that where the Spirit of the Lord is, if you and I want freedom in our lives, we have to get under the corporate anointing. We have to welcome the Holy Spirit. Freedom is only in Jesus Christ. And he whom the Son sets free, come on somebody, is free indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is all about freedom. The enemy is all about bondage. God is all about encouragement. The enemy is all about suppressing you. God is all about setting you free. The enemy is all about keeping you in chains. But I hear chains falling. Come on, somebody. I hear chains falling. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Jesus, when he's called upon in Luke 4:18, he found Isaiah 61. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is now upon me because he has anointed me. He's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, sent me to open the prison doors and set the captives free. God wants set captives free. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I break addictions off of our lives. I break every bondage. Anything holding us bound. Depression. Come on, somebody. Oppression. Fear. There's still people at home afraid to come back to church. Lord, deliver them. Loose them and set them free. Jesus Christ's name. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom. And then in John 8, verse 31, then Jesus said to those Jews who believed him, if you abide in my word, you are my disciples indeed, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. It's not the truth shall make you free. It's the truth that you know will make you free. You and I are held accountable for what we know. And thank God for a full gospel church that we hear the whole gospel without compromise. And as we hold on to that truth, praise God, you shall know the truth. And that is what will make you free. And then, of course, in John 17, verse 17, these are the words of Jesus. Jesus says, sanctify them by your truth. Your word is truth. That's why you got to get into the word every day. Because the word is truth. And that's what's going to do. When you're filled with the word, when the lie comes along, and remember, every stronghold is built on a lie, you will recognize the lie and the counterfeit because you are filled with the word, and the word is truth. Let's all stand up. Bow your heads with me for just a moment and close your eyes as heads are bowed, eyes are closed. If you are hearing the sound of my voice and you do not have a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to make sure you have an opportunity to invite and accept Christ into your heart, to be the Savior and the Lord of your life. I'm not talking about a religion. We all know about God, but do you know him in a personal and intimate way? Maybe there was a time you walked close with God, but you drifted away, and today he's calling you to come home, return back to your first love. God's not mad at you, he's mad about you. His arms are wide open. And he has a plan for your life that is good, to give you a future that is full of hope. And if you've never invited Christ into your heart, or you're away from God, if you just simply pray and say, dear Jesus, I repent of all of my sins. I ask you to forgive me. Come into my heart. Be my Savior. Be the Lord of my life. Fill me with peace and with the Holy Spirit. Be to me, Lord, a father and a friend. Today, Lord, I'm coming home to you. Amen. And if you prayed that prayer, may you sense his peace coming upon you right now. A peace that the world cannot give you, but a peace that the world cannot take away. In Jesus' name. We're going to invite our altar workers to come on down. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face, his countenance, to smile and to shine upon you. The Lord grant you his peace, his shalom, nothing missing, nothing broken. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, you are blessed. And everybody said, all right, get your t-shirts out at the table. The cafe is open. The resource center is open for your giving. God bless you. Have a blessed 4th of July tomorrow.